Ladies and gentlemen, please do not try to adjust your nervous systems or your emotions, because for the next 60 minutes, the East of Underground will control your soul. So what we need you all to do is get on this train with us and let us take you higher.
I was the lead guitar player in the East of Underground in Germany. When I got to Germany, one of the first things I did, I went to the Special Services Club, which happened to be right next door to my barracks, and met Hal, who was the director who was running the club and was looking for musicians. My background was mostly top 40, pop, Beatles-type music. He told me about another group that he was putting together. I'm not sure it had the name just yet, but I met the three singers first, and they already had the harmonies worked out. I mean, I was just blown away when I first, you know, heard them just singing kind of a cappella, just kind of warming up. It just was unreal. The drummer, George Daniels, had a lot of experience and professional experience. Actually, he claimed to have played with James Brown. We never questioned it because he was so good. I mean, it was very believable. He was the best drummer I've ever seen in my life. And having never really played a lot of the funk music they were playing, except maybe a few James Brown songs or, you know, My Girl, something like that in some of the groups I was in, I really was unfamiliar with most of the songs I did, but we really just kind of clicked, I must say, in a surprising manner. Everything just clicked, just right from the beginning, I thought. And I was able to contribute, you know, in a way that I didn't know that I could, you know, not being that familiar with the music. I think almost every song that they chose had meaning to all the guys. You know, I think each song they selected had something in it that said something to them, or something they wanted to say through the music. I don't think it was just random choices that they thought sounded good. I mean, I think they all thought a lot about it, you know, in choosing the, you know, the lineup of songs that we would do. I remember after the contest, I remember, I believe it was Bobby Blackman was being interviewed, and whoever it was, maybe it was the newspaper, it could have just been the guys at the recording studio, asked him where the name came from. And I remember his explaining that they considered everything back in the United States underground at the time, or at least their world, and that we were east of underground. So that was the meaning, you know, to them. You know, being in Germany, we were east of their world, which was underground back in the United States. I mean, not in some sinister way, but, you know, they never felt part of, you know, I'm sure mainstream America.
Now you dig that white man named McNamara, because that white man told you to your face that he gonna draft him 40,000 more people, and 30% of them are gonna be black.
hit me in the head with some kind of thing, man. Like, people don't really turn around, they really straighten out. But they don't do things like that, you know, like a fight, you know, all this kind of thing.
Privileged. I mean, here I was, you know, doing temporary duty in the Army. I remember Austin especially got away with murder, as far as, you know, the Army has, their dress codes and their certain length hair and sideburns, etc. Austin actually had a tremendous afro, and he was able to compact it and press it down in some kind of way and actually fit it up under a cap. But I remember at the contest, somebody said that there was a general that had come in, I guess, to take a look, and he saw Austin on stage with that hair, and he asked Hal about his hair, and Hal told him that it was a wig. So that satisfied the general's curiosity about his hair, but he got away with that the entire time he was there, and I'm assuming he left the Army, with the afro tucked up under his hat.
People, get ready. There's a train a-coming. Take one.
We were all drafted, so, you know, considering the political time, how unpopular Vietnam War was, and the mistrust of government. Those songs just, you know, are definitely a part of that time. They summarize a lot of the feelings, I'm sure. Although, I would have to say, as a group, we never sat down and talked politics, or, you know, we were never politically active or anything like that. We were just musicians. The period was like early 70s. The war was starting to wind down anyway. It was obviously, it had been going on my entire life. And I think I never asked anybody this, but I'm sure that every one of us were very relieved we never went to Vietnam. We were not necessarily unpatriotic, but we were not necessarily wanting to go fight a war that looked like we were going to lose anyway.
Bet you never lose my love while I California dream on. Tape 2.
When the tour ended, we went back. But we did play a couple more times. There were a couple more parties. And I think probably the last time we played together, I don't think we even realized that was the last time we were going to play. And then as we started to leave Germany, of course, you know, that ended it too. But we just all lost touch, and I have no idea where they all went. But I feel certain that they played music on some level after they left Germany. I've actually done a few Google searches, but I'm just amazed that none of them have contacted Wax Poetics. I mean, I would think that somebody would see this album and see their name on it and go, hey, I know him. But I'm absolutely amazed. I just wonder where they all ended up. I bet you never lose my love. All the leaves are brown.
All the leaves are brown.
And the sky is gray.
And the sky is gray.
California
leaves. California
leaves. On the sunshine winter's day.
Hey.
Oh, I went to the church last night. And I got down on my knees and prayed. That brother Blackman, tell me something. Where are you dreaming today?
I told you I'm dreaming in L.A.
Yeah? L.A.
L.A.
Alabama.
Lost.
Lost. Angela.
Lost. He's lost. He's lost.
Lost. Angela.
You lost. He's lost.
Angela.
Lost.
Angela.
All right. Very good. Brother Watson here.
Yeah, what's going on?
Where are you dreaming today?
St. Louis.
St. Louis. Boat. Boat.
Mo what? Mo trying to get home. Mo trying to get
right
home.
Right on.
You
in
show
there.
That ain't Missouri. Mo trying to get home. Anyway,
right
Mo
on
trying to
go. I'm going. Right on in there. Right on in. Well, I'm going to tell you.
Where you dreaming at?
I?
Yeah, where you?
Well, I'm dreaming from Detroit, Michigan, Motown.
Oh, man. It ain't nothing.
I am there.
We don't mess around.
But check it out. Check it out, the Motown sound. Oh!